Inward tilting. So today, this is the continuation of exercise 7.1. Now, question number 6. We have done till question number 5, now 6. So it is given that AC equals to A. So here, this is the figure they have given. So, given that AC equals to A, then AB equals to A. So AB equals to AD. Then angle BAD, so BAD equals to angle EAC, so they are all given. Now you are to prove BC equals to DE. So BC equals to DE, so this length of AC should be equal to the length of DE. Now these two are equal, so in that case you have to think that these two belong to two different triangles. Similarly, these two, they do not belong to the same triangle, they will belong to the different triangle. Now, AC equals to AE. So, AC and AE equal. So, these two cannot be the triangle. So, AEC cannot be the triangle because you have to make the triangles congruent. That is why they will belong to two different triangles. Similarly, these two also from the same two triangles. So this cannot be the same triangle like AB and AD. So it cannot be ABD. Now we're seeing this AC. So here AC, the triangle will be ACE. One is the triangle ACE and next is the triangle AED. So ACE and here AE. So here AB equals to AD, so AB equals to AD. So now here one of the triangle is, so here ABC and ADE. So by seeing, so ACE, so here let us take the triangle, so AC and AE. So here AB and AD. So now here AC, ACB. So triangle ACB, so ACB, this is one triangle, and AD, so ADE, and triangle ADE. So AC, then AE, so here AED, so AED, so it is AED. So on these terms we will take. So now, so from these two triangles, you have got AC equals to AE. So here AC is from this triangle equals to AE. So AE is from the second triangle. So it is AE. So why it is given? So it is AC equals to AE. So comparison between the two triangles. So AC equals to AE. So it is given. Next here AB. So here there is AB. So AB is from the triangle ABC. So here AB equals to AD. So AD is from this triangle. So it is also given. Now, here you got side. So you need three conditions for the triangles to be congruent. So here you got side. Now it is SS, you got side. Now this will be SSS or that will be SAS. So it is side or S, side angle, side. Let us see. So they have given one more angle BAD. So this angle equals to angle EAC. So EAC. So these two angles are equal. But the triangle is ABC. So ACB. Where if you take this triangle, if you take the triangle ACB, then it covers this angle, that is EAC. But they have given only this part. Then in the triangle AED. So AED, so till here AED, so it covers this angle. So now you have to make so these two angles equal, that is angle BAC equals to angle EAD, because AC and AB covers the angles. So AC you took AB, so AC and AB covers this angle, so that will be side angle side. So now since they have given angle BAD, so BAD, so this angle equals to angle EAC. So this part, but the triangle is BAC, which means it covers this angle BAC. So you are to make BAC. Then the next triangle is AED. So AED. So this is the triangle. So it covers this angle. That is EAD. So now, but they have given only angle BAD. So this angle equals to this angle. So you are to make angle BAC equals to angle DAE. So this angle equals to this angle. So for that, you will do angle BAD, angle BAD equals to angle EAC. So this one is given. So it is given with a question. Then you take this part, say you take this as angle say 1, this middle part, that is DAC. So we will add angle 1 or say angle DAC. So this part DAC. So this angle you will add on both sides. So DAC equals to angle EAC. EAC plus angle DAC. So DAC. That means on both sides you have added DAC. So BAD is there, EAC is there. So on both sides you have added angle DAC. So this DAC. Now BAD plus angle DAC. So BAD. So this angle plus this angle. So these two angles you will get BAC. So angle BAC equals to. Now angle EAC. So EAC. So this angle plus DAC. So these two angles you will get this part. That is angle EAD. So angle EAD. Now you see, if you take the triangle like this, say you have taken, so suppose it is ABC, and you say you got AB and AC, so AB and AC you took. That means you will take this angle. That is the sides that you took, that included angle should be taken. So that is side, angle, side. So since you took AC and AB, so here AC and AB for the triangle ABC, that is why you will take this angle. That is why you have made this angle BAC. And you took here AEAD. So you took here AEAD. So you will take this angle. That is angle EAD. So EAD. So that means side, angle, side. So this is one side and you took this side. So AB, AC. So you took AB also, you took AC also. And you took angle BAC. So BAC. So side, angle, side. That is why you have made these two angles equal. Because the triangle is ABC, where the angle covered is BAC, not BAD. And in the triangle AED, so AED, the angle should be EAD, covering this angle. Because this is the triangle, but they have given only angle EAC equal. So that is why you have made these two angles equal by adding on both sides angle DAC. So this middle angle you have added on both sides. Then you got these two angles equal. So the triangles are congruent by side, angle, side. So side, angle, side. Now, let me tell you again, AC and AE, so AC and AE, though you look this is a triangle, but these are the two parts of two different triangles. Similarly, these are the two parts of two different triangles, that is of the two same triangles. So AC, AE, AB, so AC and AB, so now here one comes ABC, this is one triangle, then the next triangle is AE. So this is one triangle and this is one triangle. So now here they have given, so these two parts are equal. So it is given, and also they have given this is also equal. Now, and they have given these two angles are equal. So from this, so now this proof. So first, you will make, as the triangle is ABC and they have given this angle, first you make this angle equals to this angle. Why? Because you have the triangle ABC. So, and the next triangle is AED. So that means in this triangle, it covers this angle, and in this triangle, it covers this angle. So that is why first you will make angle BAC equals to angle, so DAE. So now angle BAD equals to angle EAC. So it is given. It is given. Now you can add, you can just name this angle, that is DAC. So this middle angle you can name as angle 1, or simply you can add angle DAC on both sides. That is, this angle you will add on both sides. So this implies angle BAD plus angle DAC. So this angle DAC, so equals to angle EAC. So EAC plus angle DAC. That means adding angle DAC on both sides. Adding this angle on both sides. So you got here angle BAD. So BAD plus DAC. So these two angles, if you add, you will get this bigger angle, that is angle BAC. So angle BAC, so BAC equals to, then you got EAC plus DAC. So you got here, so this plus this, you got this angle. Adding these two parts, you have got this angle, that means angle DAE. So angle DAE. Now you will make the triangles converge. So as I have told you, they belong to the two different triangles. These do not belong to the same triangle. Similarly, these two do not belong to the same triangle. They will belong to the two different triangles. So now in triangle. So in triangle ABC. So ABC and triangle. So as you have taken, see these two are equal. So here AC equals to A. So here AB equals to AD. So AB and AD are. So you took ABC, you will take ADE. So this is the second triangle. So triangle ADE. Now you will make the, you will take the corresponding parts of these two triangles. So one is the triangle ABC covering this angle. One is the triangle ADE covering this angle. So you have made these two angles equal here. So now here you got AC equals to AD, because AC is the part of the triangle ABC, because AC is present in triangle ABC. So these letters are present. That means AC is a part of the triangle ABC. AE is a part of the triangle ADE. So why it is equal? So it is given. So it is given. Next is AB equals to AB. So from the triangle ABC, you will take AB. So here AB equals to AB. So AB equals to AD. So AD is in triangle ADE. So AD. This one is also given. Now just you take one simple triangle. So you take one of the triangle ACAB. So ACAB. So you got side and side. That means these two sides include, AB and AC includes the angle BAC. So side, angle, side. Already you have made the angles equal. So here angle BAC equals to angle DAE. DAE, this is proof thereof. So you have proved here. So they have just given BAD, but you got BAC. So you took BAC, why? Why you did not take BAD? Because AC and AB makes the angle BAC, and AE and AD makes the angle AE. So they are called the included angle. So it is proved above. So you have got this one by proving above. So you got 3 points, 1, 2, 3. So now you took two sides. So you took AC, you took AB, and you took BAC. So BAC, so side, angle, side. So therefore, triangle ABC congruence to triangle ADE by SAS congruence, side angle side. So as the two triangles are congruent, which means if you place the triangle ABC over triangle ADE, they will look the same. That means same shape, same size. Now their corresponding parts will be equal. So therefore, you will get BC equals to DE. So here BC equals to DE. So therefore, BC equals to DE by CPCD. As I told you, CPCD comes only after congruence. This word will never come before congruence. Corresponding parts of congruent triangles. So as the two triangles are congruent, that is why the remaining parts. So parts can be the sides, corresponding sides, or the corresponding angles, but you need the sides. So that is why BC equals to DE CPC. So it is proved. So first you will make this angle equals to this angle, because you have got the triangle ABC. In this triangle ABC, the angle is this, and in this triangle, the angle is this. So that is why you have made these two angles equal, and the remaining two is this. So it is given. So the two triangles are congruent by SAS. Let us take 7. So it is given. AB is a line segment. Line segment. And P is its midpoint. And P is its midpoint. D and E are points on the same side of AB such that angle BAD is equal to angle ABE, angle EBA equals to angle DB. Triangle DAP congruence to triangle EBP. So here the figure is given. So AB is a line segment. So here AB is a line segment. So this is a line segment, and P is its midpoint. That means P is the middle point of AB, which means AB equals to BP. P is its midpoint. That means P is the midpoint of line segment AB. So AB equals to BP. This one is given. So midpoint. D and E are points. So this D and E are points on the same side of AB. So this is the line segment AB. On the same side, there are two points D and E on the same side, such that angle BAD. So BAD. So BAD. So this angle equals to angle ABE. So ABE. So ABE. So these two angles are equal. And angle EBA. So EBA. So this angle EBA. So this angle equals to angle DBB. So DBB. So these two angles are equal. So these are the things they have given. Now you want to prove triangle DAP. So in triangle DAP, it covers this angle. So the same is like that. Previous sum you have done in 6. Question number 6. So here the triangle is DAP. So DAP. So you see this is the triangle. So if this is the triangle, it will cover this much angle. But they have given that this angle, only this much, that is angle EPA equals to angle DBB. Next they have given triangle EBB. So EBB. So in triangle EBB, it covers this angle. So that means now again you will make, so if this is the triangle, if triangle is APB, you are to make angle APD equals to angle. So and the next triangle is this, next triangle is EPB, so covering this much angle. So that means you will make angle EPB, so EPB, so EPB equals to angle this angle, because the next triangle is this APB, so DPA. So you will make these two angles equal. So you have got one part, you are going to make these two angles equal as you have done in 6, question number 6. So you will make these two angles equal because the triangles are DPA covering this much angle and the next triangle is EBP covering this much angle. So you will make in this triangle angle APD. So this angle equals to angle EPB. So these two angles must be equal. Then in this triangle you got this angle A, and in this triangle you got B. So these two angles are equal. So here A and B is equal. A and B. So B and D. So B A D means angle A, and A B E means it means angle B. So these two angles are also equal. So you got two things. One is by adding this angle EPD on both sides of this, you will get this angle and this angle equal. That is one. Next one, you will get here A and B. So this A and B equal. That is the second one. So you need one more. So that point will be P is the midpoint of AB. So on this line segment AB, P is the midpoint, which means AP equals to BP. AP is for the triangle DAP and for the triangle EPB BP. So AP and BP is equal because P is the midpoint of AB. So they have given here. So the two triangles are congruent by, so let us take one triangle, say DAP. So you took this angle, you took this angle, and you took this side. So in the triangle DAP, you took angle A. Why? Because A with B corresponds, and this angle corresponds with this angle, which means equal. Then AP and BP is equal. So on this triangle, you took this angle and you took this angle. So two angles on a side. So the triangles will be congruent by angle, side, angle. So as the two triangles are congruent, so their corresponding parts are also equal, which means AD equals to BE by simplicity. Because as the two triangles are congruent, meaning same shape and the same size, so their corresponding parts are also equal. So the parts are AD of the triangle DAP and BE of the triangle EBP. So these two parts are equal because of simplicity. So now, number one, we are going to prove this. Before that, so you got AP equals to BP. So in both the triangle, you got AP and BP is equal. So because P is the midpoint of AB, next you got angle A from this triangle, that is DAP. So A equals to angle B, that is EBP. So one more is there. So that is, they have given EPA is equal to DPB. So these two angles are equal. You will add EPD on both sides. That means you will add this middle part on both sides. This plus this, you will get this angle. This plus this, you will get this angle. So now, angle EPA equals to angle DPB. So DPB. So EPA. So this angle equals to angle DPB. So these two angles are equal. Why? So it is given. It is given. It is given in the question. So as these two angles are equal, but you need to make this angle equals to this angle. Why? Because the triangle will be this one. So in this triangle it will cover this angle, and in this triangle it will cover this angle. So now on both sides, angle EPA plus angle EPD. So this middle part you will have both sides. So EPD is equal to angle DPB plus angle EPD. So EPD. So you will get, so EPA, so EPA, so this angle plus EPD. So this and this angle, you will get this angle. So adding these two angles, you got APD. So angle APD. And adding angle DPB, so this angle with this, you have got this angle. So the sum of these two angles, you will get this angle. That is BPE. So angle BPE. Now, in triangle, so DAB. So you will make these two triangles converge. So you will take these two triangles. Now in triangle DAB and triangle EBP. So EBP. So you got in this triangle. So as these three letters are there in DAB, so the angle is P, and in this triangle the angle is P. So angle APD equals to angle BPE. So you got by proved above. So proved above. Then next they have given that P is the midpoint of AB. That is, P is the middle point of line segment AB. P lies exactly in the middle of AB. That means AB equals to BP. So AB is in the triangle DAB AB. And BP, so BP is present in the triangle EBP. So here P is midpoint. Why they are equal? So P is midpoint of AB. So AB. So you have got one, two. Then one more is there. So they have given angle A and B equal. So there is A. That means BAD means PAD, because the triangle is PAD. So now here angle. So here BAD. So indicating angle A, so that means PAD. So it is PAD is equal to angle. So here PAD is equal to angle PBE. So here A and B is equal. So it is given angle A, angle B. So it will be angle PBE. So PBE. So it is given. So this means this one. So 1, 2, 3. So three parts you got, three pairs of corresponding parts. So therefore, triangle DAB congruence to triangle, so EBP, so EBP by, so you got in this triangle, so you got this angle and this side. So angle side angle. So by ASA, so ASA the triangles are congruent. So therefore, as the two triangles are congruent, therefore AD, so AD equals to BE. So AD equals to BE by CPCD. So it is by CPCD. So proved. ABC, in right triangle ABC, angle C equals to 90 degrees. Then M is midpoint of hypotenuse AB, C is joint C C is joined to, C is joined to M, N is produced. N is produced to, N is produced to a point D, to a point D, such that DM equals to CM, CM, then point D is joined to B. So point D is joined to point B. Now here they have given all detailed four, so I will be writing the first two. So to prove, number one, triangle AMC congruence to triangle, so BMD, so BMD, and number two, say it is angle DBC, angle DBC equals to, so right angle, that is 90. Okay, now in right triangle ABC, so right triangle ABC, angle C is 90 degree, that is right angle, 90 degree. N is the midpoint of hypotenuse AB. So N is the midpoint, so N is the middle point of the line segment AB. So as this is 90 degree, this is the hypotenuse. So in this hypotenuse, so N is the midpoint of AB, so you can mark it. Then BM equals to AM, because N is the midpoint of line segment AB, that is the hypotenuse AB. Then C is joined to M, so C and M is joined, N is produced to point D. So C is joined to M, C is joined to M, N is produced to point D, and from here extended to D, this is point D, such that DM equals to CM. So here DM and CM are equal. Now here they say the first one, prove that triangle AMC congruence to triangle BMD. Now one thing you see, we can write simply that AMC, if you take, you can't write DMB, because AB, so AM, so AM and BM are equal, so AM and BM are equal, so there's a single marking. M is the midpoint of AB, so if you take triangle BMD, you are bound to take AMC, or if you take DMB, you will take CMA, because the sides should correspond. Now proof, so in triangle AMC and triangle BMD, so BMD, so BMD, D. So in these two triangles, so AMC and BMD, what did you get? So in triangle AMC and BMD, you got AM is equal to BM. So AM is in the triangle, is a part of the triangle AMC, and BM is the part of the triangle BMD. In BMD, here BM is present, and the triangle AMC, AM is present. So AM is equal to BM. Why? Because here they have given M is midpoint. So M is midpoint of AB. So here, first one. Next, the line segment AB and DC, so these two line segments meet at point M, intersecting at point M. So the pair of opposite angles also will be equal, because these two lines intersect at point M, the forming a pair of vertically opposite angles. So these two angles also will be equal. So it is vertical. So angle AMC equals to, so AMC is equal to angle BMD. So these two angles will be equal. So angle BMD, why? It is vertically opposite angles. So you got two conditions, you need one more. So the one more is that CM equals to DM. So CM is the part of the triangle ANC, because CM is present here in the triangle ANC, and DM is the part of the triangle BMD, where DM is present in BMD. So here CM is equal to DM. Why? Why it is? Because here they have given. So it is given in the given part. So it is DM. So it is given. Now, so therefore, so 1, 2, 3. So you've got three pairs of corresponding parts. So therefore, triangle AMC congruence to triangle BMD by. Now to arrive at the criteria, you just take a single triangle. So you took AM, you took AM, you took CM in a single triangle. So you took AM and CM in this triangle, and you took angle AMC, you took this angle. So side, angle, side. So that means these two triangles are congruent by side, angle, side. Or you have taken DM and BM in this triangle, and you took this angle, so side, angle, side. So by SAS criteria. Criteria. So now your first one is complete. Now you need DBC 90 degree. That means this angle should be 90. But they have given this angle is 90. That is, right angle triangle angle C is given as 90 degree. So it's given. So now how to arrive at this? So now here the letters, the way of writing a triangle according to their correspondence is very, very important. So you cannot write triangle AMC congruence to triangle say MBD or BMB. No, that will be wrong, because A should match with B, M should match with M, and C should match with D. Similarly, AM equals to BM, you will get AM and BM, CM and DM, so CM and DM, and you take the angle M, so you will get this and this. So in this way, that should match always. Now, to get DBC, let us take their ways of doing. So as these two triangles were congruent, so you are going to derive how? If you do not get it in the given part, you are now going to derive the second proof from the first proof. So for this, you will just have to see a little bit. So as these two triangles are congruent, that is why angle A and angle B corresponds. It means that if you go according to their correspondence in terms of angles using these letters, then angle A corresponds with angle B and angle C corresponds with angle B. So it means, so here in this triangle here, A means this angle, that means angle. That means as these two triangles are congruent naturally, so angle A will be equal to angle B. So here B is in the triangle DMB. So DMB, because you have proved these two triangles congruent, there is no connection with this triangle. So you will see this. As these two triangles are congruent, therefore angle A corresponds with angle B, or angle C corresponds with angle D, or C and D. So this angle in this triangle and this angle in this triangle. So as B and A is equal by simplicity, but they form a pair of angles. So that angle is, so these two angles are equal if you see in this way. So these two angles are equal. There is B, there is A, there is C, and here it is D. Now these two angles are equal. So this and this angle is equal. So they form a pair of alternate interior angles. So DB is parallel to AC. So now, number two, angle, so here now MAC, you can go from this. So angle A corresponds with B. So MAC, you can take this well. So angle MBD. So MBD. As these two triangles are congruent, so since simplicity, it is by simplicity, corresponding parts of convex triangles. As these two triangles are convex, so you got this. So they form a pair of, they form, so as these two angles, so this angle and this angle is equal, but they form a pair of alternate interior angles because the line segment AB intersect DB and AC at A and B respectively. So they form a pair of alternate interior angles. So that is why DB is parallel to AC. They form a pair of alternate interior angles. So these two, they form a pair of alternate interior angles. Therefore DB is parallel. So DB is parallel. So as this and these two angles are equal and this line segment AB intersects, so forming the angle with this line and this line, and they are the alternate, so this DB is parallel to AC. So DB is parallel to AC. If DB is parallel to AC, then if here these two lines are parallel and this line intersect, then these two angles total will be 180 degree co-interior angles, or the sum of the adjacent interior angles. Now as DB is parallel to AC, intersected by the lines segment BC, so these two angles total sum will be 180 degree due to co-interior angles. So this plus this, that is the sum of the adjacent interior angles will be 180. So this angle plus this angle. So therefore angle DBC plus angle ACB, so ACB equals to 180 degree. So the reason is co-interior, or the sum of the adjacent interior angles. So this gives angle DBC. So this is not given, you are to prove this angle as 90, but here they have given right angle at C. So here angle C is 90 degree. So 90 is equal to 180. So you will get here angle DBC is equal to, so you get this side, you will get 90 degree. So the second one is proved. Now the third one, number three, triangle DBC congruence to triangle ACB. So ACB. So the third proof, you have proved the first two. Now the third proof of the same equation. So triangle DBC. So DBC. So this triangle should be congruence to triangle ACB. So this triangle should be congruent to this triangle. So now in these two triangles, what can we get? Just you think that in the first one, you have proved these two triangles congruent, A, M, C, and B, and D. So these two triangles were congruent. Then you got these two lines were parallel also, because as these two triangles were congruent, so you got this angle and this angle equal, or this angle D corresponds with angle C. That time also they will form a pair of alternate angles. As a result, DD will be parallel to AC. Now here you got, so you got this angle also now 90 degree, you got DEC. So to prove these two triangles congruent, first one is DBC and ACB 90 degree. And these two triangles have the common base BC. BC, BC. So they have got the common side BC. This is the common base. And one more you need. One is 90. Both the angles will be 90 from both the triangles. 90. Next one is, this is the common side for both the triangles. Here BC is present. And one more you need. That is, you have made these two triangles congruent. That is A and C congruence triangle B and D. From where you got BD equals to AC, CD, CD. When these two triangles were congruent in number one, that time all the corresponding parts are also equal. So that is why DB and AC are equal. So DB is present in triangle DBC, AC is present in triangle ACB. So how this DBM AC are equal? Because you have proved in one that triangle DMB congruent to triangle CME. So from there you have got DB is equal to AC. So now angle, so here DB is equal to AC. Now it will not be CPCD, because CPCD means directly by proving the triangle's congruent, when you use that X line, then you can write CPCD. Now you are going to tell the main reason, not CPCD. You will tell that these two are equal because triangle AMC, you have made triangle AMC congruent to triangle BMD in number 1, so BMD. So as these two triangles we have met congruence in question number 1, so that is why DB and AC are equal. Then you got this angle also 90, and this one is given in the question as 90 degree. So angle DBC is equal to angle ACB equals to 90. So then the last one is both the triangles, they have the common base BC, because the triangles they lie on or they stand on the same base BC, and here you see BC is present. So BC equals to BC. So it's the common side. Common side. So therefore triangle DBC congruent to triangle ACD by, now you get this triangle. So you took the side DB, you took the side BC in this triangle DBC, and you took this angle. So this side you took, and this angle you took, and you took the side BC. So the triangles are congruent by side, angle, side. So by SAS, the triangles are congruent. Then number 4, you are to prove that CM equals to half of AB. So this is the last proof of this question, that is number 4. So CM should be half of AB. Now as you have proved that triangle DBC congruent to triangle ACB, so this triangle is congruent to this triangle, that means from this you got that their corresponding parts are equal. So when I say corresponding parts as your requirement, if you need the angles corresponding, you can take the angles. If you need the segments, you can take the segments. So here, according to this, I will take here, so CM and AB. So S here, so D, so here DC. So DC equals to AB, AB. So DC, as these two triangles were congruent, as these two triangles are congruent, so you need CM should be half of AB. So you don't need the angles, or you do not need the other things. So you are to connect them with the means hypotenuse. So in this triangle here, AB is the hypotenuse, and as this one is also 90 degree as proved, this is also the hypotenuse. So you will make the two hypotenuse equal because they are congruent. So DC equals to AB. So DC equals to AB since. So here you can write triangle DBC congruent to triangle ACB. So from here you got. Then here AB is present. Okay. So you take half on both sides. So you take half. That means dividing by 2 on both sides. So here half of AB is there. Now half of DC. DC half. So as the CM and DM are equal, so CM plus DM, you will get DC, but these two are equal. So as these two parts are equal, CM and DM, so they have given as equal. So the markings are there. So that means half of CM, that means half of CM, half of DC means that will be CM or that will be DM, because these two are halves of DC, because L is the midpoint of DC. So half of DC, you can write CM or half of DC, you can write DA. So here half of DC, DC half, so these are halves. So C. So here CN equals to half of AB. Reason is since CN is equal to DA. So the first exercise is complete. So with this we have come to the end of today's class. Thank you.